When I was a teenager, I probably was the only one around that took photographs and 8mm film of the car clubs, car club meetings, of the cars, going to the beach with my sleeper jacket, and the girls would wear them, and that was a lot of fun. A lot of my friends would call me up and they had an accident and they'd say, come take a photograph of my accident. I might need it for insurance purposes, or maybe, Kramer, you could sell it to our local paper, which I did, and I got $2.50 for each photo. The group of people that you're going to meet in this film have been my friends for over 50 years, and I'm really proud of them. What I think is so cool is we still go to Perry's Delicatessen after 20 years and we meet with all the old guys. And
yeah, you gonna go this Friday?
Yeah, we go Monday, Wednesday, and then Friday, everybody's supposed to be there.
Right.
20 years we've been doing
it. 20 years.
Love it.
Yeah.
Come here, pretty mama. Sit down on your daddy's knee.
We were just kids having fun, going to school, enjoying our teenage years. We really didn't get into politics or worry a lot about what was going on, because at that time everything was really great.
You put it in gear at a dead stop, you burn rubber, and you like to hear the noise, you like to smell the burning rubber. Tires didn't last too long in those days. Yeah, everybody did that. Everybody.
A bunch of us in the late 50s would get bored and go out and buy a bunch of old cars. A friend of mine bought an old Studebaker for $15, and I bought a 1935 Chevy for only $50. The other guys went out and bought these old cars, and we used to call them Al Capone cars. We'd take them out to the open space called Flat Track in Santa Fe, California, and we raced them around the hills. I remember the trunk flapping like crazy when we were flying over the big bumps. We ran into each other, and the last one running was the winner. We even crashed a few of these Capone cars over the cliff. Most of us remember the amazing movie, written and directed by George Lucas, American Graffiti. I was lucky enough to be part of that scene in Santa Fe, California.
What was your favorite scene in American Graffiti?
I like the 57 T-Bird with Suzanne Summers as the actress.
Did you have a crush on her?
Yeah, back then.
Tell me about that.
Oh, just that she's very new to the industry and very good looking. And I just like the way they did the scene.
What did you say?
Wait, what did you say? What did you say?
We had a real good poker run that started in Santa Fe, went to Vichy Springs, and we had a band called James Brown and his Famous Flames play for us. I don't know if anybody remembers that from around here. I think Marty does. And nobody believes me. We had James Brown play for our end of our poker run. That was a fun day. Do you remember when we had a dance called the Sleepwalk and the Sugar Pie and Pee Wee? You remember, anybody remember Sugar Pie and Pee Wee?
No. Yes.
And anyway, she's still alive, and she lives in Oakland, and she's still performing once a year.
Forget about the pearl for a while. You
I was at a car show in Santa Fe, and a friend asked me if I ever heard of the pinstripe lady. I said, nope. He said she's a model, an artist, a painter, and one of the best pinstripers on the West Coast. I connected with her in Santa Rosa, and she agreed to do an interview.
And then sometimes I go back in and clean up my lines. I like my work a little bit heavier. The finer line is nice sometimes, and I can get it finer than that, but I prefer a heavier line, especially on a car like this. As you can see, I tried to emulate Don's style a little bit and make it so it's a compliment to the inside of the car here. He actually did this little mural, and it's a nod to the Pharaoh's car from American Graffiti. And it's actually signed by Bo Hopkins, the actor who played the president of the Pharaoh's Car Club. I took my troubles down to Madame Rue.
You know that gypsy with the gold kept you. She's you are successful. And you join the Pharaoh's with a car coat and a blood initiation and all that, huh?
What? Wait a minute. What's blood initiation?
What was your favorite car in the movie, Bob?
The coupe. Coupe? Just like Marty said, it was more realistic to the day as far as when we altered 4th Street.
Hey, Ludo!
Hey, Miller!
Hey, man, what happened to your flathead?
Huh?
What happened to your flathead?
Your mother.
What?
Your mother! Hey, we've been talking about you.
Yeah?
Yeah, there's a very wicked 55 Chevy looking for you.
Makeup.
Thank you.
Makeup.
I love it.
Bob and Joni have been married over 50 years, and they still reminisce about the car clubs today.
All those guys were fun, fun-loving, but they really loved their cars more than the girls. I mean, he was crazy. And most of his friends that are in this movie, if you will, they all love their cars, and they all go to all the car shows, and they all win.
Spark Plug Cowboys, woo!
We hang with some of the guys he went to grade school and high school with. They haven't changed, they're great friends, and they're still crazy about their cars, they still go to car shows, and they still talk about the same things. I love that.
Hey, schoolgirl, how you going? I pass your house because of this. Your mama told me you're going out to play. Hey, school girl, how you going, mama? Let me bring your books home, baby. Feels so good today.
No, I didn't watch much TV, but my favorite crazy commercials I loved. There was just a lot of crazy, wild commercials.
Yeah, they were good in those days. A little bit different than they do now, not so well made.
Yeah, they don't swear now. And these ones I saw, they swearing like crazy.
You've read it in the newspapers. In fact, perhaps you've even seen the owner's picture. Ralph Williams, the owner of Bayshore Chrysler Plymouth, 345 El Camino Real in the city of San Bruno. You notice the big bald-headed son of a bitch? The man that came to San Francisco to offer them more for the dollar they spend. The man that came to San Francisco to rape each and every citizen and the whole San Francisco Bay Area. You don't believe it? Listen to me. I don't lie. Take a fucking car like this. A 1966 Ford, a Country Squire 9-passenger station wagon. Don't worry about the equipment. Imagine all the fun you can have in the back. And while you're doing it, imagine all the money that that bald-headed prick Ralph Williams is going to be making on the car he's trying to fuck you out of.
Use Dixie Peach pomade, which was like Vaseline with a little smell to it. And you comb your hair into a, like what you called a can opener. And then you leave the sides long in the back and you'd go into a DA.
Sometimes, however, even a normally reliable head of hair fails to rise to the occasion. And in emergencies like this, when it just isn't long enough, a switch of false hair is thrust into the breach. Not everyone's cup of tea, but this is no time to split hairs. To Cyril, the new style is a work of art. To the customer, it's a mark of distinction. To other folk, it looks like an elephant's trunk, which is just what it is called. We repeat, the elephant's trunk.
Jumping forward to self-driving cars, the newest thing. I thought it would be fun to ask the old-timers, like myself, what they thought.
It's a good idea. I can sit back, read a book, and the car will take me where I want to go. That sounds pretty cool.
No way. It's making the turn for you. How, man? Do I have to press the gas still?
Nope.
You can let go.
I can?
Yep.
No way, dude. This is nuts, man.
The worst thing that ever happened to this country. Self-driving cars.
No way can I see having a car that's going to drive me somewhere.
On your knee, buttons up.
For use of the steering wheel in front of you. Fold it up swiftly for holding your coffee and papers. Or tilt it down as your personal working station, keyboard included.
We had no idea that there were car clubs around the world. We thought only in Marin County there was car clubs and nothing else was going on around the world.
We had fun. It was a lot of fun. And all clubs had something in common. This was such a golden time. And I don't think it ever can be replaced. I knew people from CAM, from San Rafael, from all the schools, because you'd be visiting, you'd be meeting in drive-ins, you'd be going to functions or parties or dances, and it was a great time. It's a great time.
I'm gonna stay with it, baby. Like it's to be 99.
Sweetheart, good night.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go home. Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go home. I hate to leave you. I really must say, oh, good night, sweetheart. Good night. Well, it's 3 o'clock. Morning, baby, I just can't get right. Well.